Hello everyone, welcome to the session on isometric projection of engineering graphics. Now, moving on to the third problem related with isometric view in vertical way, you can see a problem is given as a hexagonal lamina of size 25 mm is resting vertically on one of its corners on HP with its adjacent sides inclined equally to HP. The plane of lamina is parallel to VP. Draw its isometric view. It's being told that there is a lamina, that is hexagonal lamina of size 25 mm, and it's being said that it is resting on one of its corners. It is resting on one of its corners directly on HP with its adjacent sides inclined equally to HP. You can see adjacent sides. These are adjacent sides. It is inclined equally to HP. If the plane of the lamina is parallel to VP, draw its isometric view. First of all, draw the hexagonal lamina such that it resting on one corner and two sides, adjacent sides, are equally inclined. So this is a front view. Okay. After drawing this, you have to enclose this hexagon in with a rectangle. Okay. Enclose it with a rectangle. Okay. Says that it passes through all the corners. It passes through all the corners. After which you are asked to draw the isometric view of it. So you can create the vertical isometric view by drawing a baseline, then inclining this side, that is DC. You can incline DC 30 degrees. After inclining it, from this front view itself, you will know the measurement of DC. So, after drawing a 30 degree incline line, please transfer this measurement, D dash C dash measurement, over here. So, thus you will get DC. Then transfer D dash A dash to a vertical line. That is, you have to draw a vertical line over here. Transfer D dash A dash measurement over here, so that you get DA. Similarly, construct AB and BC. Okay, such that AB is parallel to CD and BC is parallel to AD. Okay, after which you can take all the measurements in compass, like D dash, 6 dash you can take, plot it over here. Similarly, D dash, 5 dash you take, plot it over here. Then A dash, 1 dash you take measurement with a compass from here and then transfer it over here. Similarly, A dash, 2 dash you take, transfer it over here, A2. Next day, take B dash 2 dash, transfer as B2. Then take B dash 3 dash, transfer over here to get B3. Then you take C dash 4 dash, transfer it over here to get C4. Then C dash 5 dash to get C5. After which the complete isometric view in vertical will be complete. Okay. Similarly, you can go for the horizontal method also, which I have dealt in the previous session. Now, moving on to another question of, that is the front view of quadrilateral ABCD whose surface is parallel to VP is shown in the figure below. One of the included angles is 60 degree. Draw the isometric view. If you are asked to draw the isometric view, either a horizontal one or a vertical one, first of all, this is the figure that is given to you. 60 degree inclination is there. All of the sides are given. This is a quadrilateral. Yeah. First, you enclose it in a rectangle such that it passes through all the corners. In this way, you can see the front view. It is enclosed with a rectangle. Okay. Then what you need to do is drop a vertical line from C dash. From C dash, drop a vertical line to F dash, E dash. Similarly, from C dash, drop a horizontal line to E dash, B dash. Okay. Then, now we are going to draw the vertical isometric view. For that, go for a baseline. After which, go for A dash, A1, B1. That is having the same length as A dash, B dash. Then go for a vertical line A1, F1, which is having the same measurement as A dash, F dash. Then you create F1, E1, which is parallel to A1, B1. Then you create E1, B1, which is parallel to F1, A1. And the measurements are also similar. F1, A1 is equal to E1, B1. F1, E1 is equal to A1, B1. Okay. Now what you need to do is measure F1 D dash and transfer it to F1 D1. Okay, so you'll get a point here. Now join A1 D1. Okay, next what you have to do is measure E dash H dash and transfer it as E1 H1. Similarly, measure E dash G dash and transfer it as E1 G1. Okay, then you drop a vertical line, drop a horizontal line. The coinciding point will be your C1. Okay, thus you have got C1. Now you join A1 D1, then D1 C1, then after which you join C1 B1. So this is the vertical isometric view. Similarly, you can go for horizontal isometric view. Similarly, you can draw it, but only thing is that when you're drawing the horizontal isometric view, you have to see that these two inclinations are 30 degree. That is, two sides are inclined 30 degree with the baseline. With this, I'm finishing off today's lecture. Thank you.